Here we have receptor tyrosine kinases. And a tyrosine is an amino acid. So right here, this is a polypeptide. It's a protein that has is made of amino acids. And the amino acid that we are specifically dealing with, though, in this is tyrosine. And so when we look at how this works, here we have a signal binding site. This is where the ligand or the receptor or the signaling molecule is going to attach. These red circles represent the signaling molecules. And examples of these in real life would be like insulin or growth factor. They're going to be received by receptor tyrosine kinases. So here, to point out what a kinase is an enzyme that catalyzes the transfer of phosphate groups. So if we think about that, if ATP has three phosphates, let's just draw three of them, a kinase is going to take off one of these phosphates and put it onto something else. So here we have receptor tyrosine kinases. So seeing that the word kinase is in the title, that's going to imply that these are going to be transferring phosphate groups. So let's go ahead and see how this works. So here we have when the signaling molecule like insulin or growth factor comes and attaches to that signal binding site, these two separate polypeptides are going to aggregate or come together like this. And then here we call this a dimer. Now right now this dimer is unphosphorylated, but it does have activated tyrosine regions. So at this point, these tyrosine regions that are going to act as kinases are activated. So remember, a kinase transfers phosphate groups. So what happens is they're going to take a phosphate off of ATP, this phosphate right here, and attach it, let's clear this off, and attach it to one of the tyrosines. Now, in reality, what's happening, the tyrosine kinase on this side is attaching the phosphate to here, and vice versa. So eventually this one will attach a phosphate to here. So they kind of phosphorylate each other. So again, the kinase activity is basically taking phosphates from ATP and then phosphorylating this dimer. Okay, so now we have a fully phosphorylated dimer and fully activated tyrosine kinase regions. So at this point, we've had the message come in, but yet we haven't seen any like steps leading to a cell response. So the next step that's going to happen is we're going to have these relay proteins. So this is a separate protein coming in. And this protein will go through a conformational change in shape. You can see here how the shape changes. And that's going to then lead to its own signal transduction pathway and a cellular response. Then you have a different relay protein come in and be activated by a different tyrosine region. And so now that one goes through a conformational change in shape. And that will activate a different signal transduction pathway and lead to a different cell response. So there can be multiple cell responses all from one binding activity. And so within a cell, if this were insulin, you're going to have a whole bunch of changes happening within this cell to bring about bringing down blood sugar levels. Or if this was a cell going through mitosis and cell division, you would have a whole bunch of things that need to happen inside that cell in order for it to become two. And so receptor tyrosine kinases are really cool because it's just one signaling event, just one signaling molecule coming in to attach, and yet you can have multiple cell responses from that.